Hi, I'm Istvan, the founder and CEO of Shapr3D, and I've been waiting for this day for 12 months to finally show you what we built. I spend a lot of time with our community. I spend hours every single day talking with you, reading your feedback, answering your questions on our forum, and what makes me truly happy when we can make you happy. And today, I know that we will make many, many of you incredibly happy. Because today, we are launching a brand new workflow in Shapr3D that has been one of the most requested features by our design and manufacturing community. A workflow that will completely change how hundreds of thousands of Shapr3D users design. In the last 30 years, everything has changed, except for CAD. CAD somehow got stuck in the 1990s. And when we started Shapr 6 years ago, we had this bold conviction that we can change the status quo. First, we built an Apple Design Award-winning professional design tool for iPad and Apple Pencil that made 3D design 3 to 5 times faster according to our customers. The next natural step in the evolution of Shapr3D was to add manufacturing drawings so you can get from concepts to manufacturing 3 times faster compared to traditional CAD apps. And finally, last year, we launched Shapr3D on macOS and Windows so you can seamlessly switch between your devices as it should be in 2022. And 6 years later, with 140 team members, there is still a lot more we can do to improve your design process. So today, we are launching a brand new workflow in Shapr3D. With this tool, you will be able to visualize your designs 10 times faster. Communicate your ideas without any misunderstandings. Run design reviews like never before and get instant client approvals. You will be able to iterate on dozens of design variations within minutes. This is visualization.
We're super excited to be here. This is a true game changer for our users and their workflows. We've been talking to many of our users over the last few years, and we've heard about 3 typical situations which we think this would be great for. First, when you're at a client pitching your designs. Second, when you're working with your team and you need to see a range of different options. And third, when you're on the go and inspiration hits. These problems might seem familiar to you, but what's the problem with current solutions? Marty?
Yeah, so the thing is, existing CAD software is simply not client-facing. It's challenging to present your ideas effectively to customers. Workflow or UX issues prevent you from showing off your models or iterating on them quickly. One of our users, Adam Miklosi, is an industrial designer by profession and also winner of multiple Red Dot Design Awards. He's seen all of it when it comes to visualization. When he's doing a client presentation or a design review, he might need to do small adjustments on the spot, something which is almost impossible with most rendering apps today. Now, he will just take his iPad and present his design, and that's it. He can tweak his models on the spot and visualize the differences right away.
Yep, visualization was created for moments just like this. We expect it's going to help our users have an amazing design workflow. Let's not just talk about it. Here's a camera that we modeled in Shapr3D. Let's see how visualization helps breathe life into it.
Okay, let's see how it goes. This is my camera in the Shapr3D modeling space. It's the regular view of the model, something what you're already familiar with. Now, just two taps, and I'm in visualization mode. It takes less than a second to get there. With other tools, switching from modeling to visualization is just clumsy. It's tedious to show off my work on a desktop PC waiting for everything to boot. Or I can pick a third-party app, but then I can't make any tweaks on the spot. And when one of these scenarios happens, my workflow suffers quite a bit. So, now that we are in visualization space, let's start with the basics here. Visualization fits perfectly in the Shapr3D workflow. It's super easy to use. Even if you have zero prior experience with the rendering tool, you'll pick up the basics in seconds. All it takes is a single tap, and then a flick of a finger, and your selected material is right there on your object. It's that simple. Of course, I can change these materials anytime I want with the same gesture. Look, it's super easy. I can even do it with my Apple Pencil. Either way, in a few seconds, my camera comes alive. On the side, you can see all the used materials. Right below, you have the material library as well. Any material you use on your object will pop up in the top selection. This helps you when working on more complex objects with several materials applied to them. You can expand or collapse this menu as you go along.
Okay, now let's talk about materials. Ease of use is one thing, but having an awesome selection of materials to choose from is just as important. Samuele Meda, head of design at Kenwood, is an avid Shapr3D user, and he's been using the new visualization feature with his team. Having a great selection of materials to choose from has been a game changer for their workflow.
Right, that's why visualization comes with over 70 materials and a handful of finishes. But that's just the beginning. We're planning to add more materials in new releases. Now, let's take a look at them. Okay, so you will see that my material library is grouped by material types. We start with fabrics and then glass. Let's apply that refractive glass on our camera lens. So let's continue with something different. Let's go with standard chrome for our camera. It's looking super shiny now. But what if I also want to make it look more precious? Yes, I'm thinking of a polished gold part. Let's just drop it down here. Very good. But plastics are also an important piece of the visualization tool. I'm now thinking of keeping things simple. Let's see ABS on the camera body. Okay, that gives us a cool retro vibe. Or maybe I want something more modern, so let's apply carbon fiber on it. Very nice.
Okay, now we've seen a number of materials in action, but I'm thinking this camera would look awesome in Shapr3D Blue.
Why not? It's just as easy as you'd imagine. Let me show you. Let's see our carbon fiber. If I drag the scale slider, you will see how the material gets more intricate. This helps you a lot to adjust the scale depending on the size of the object you are working on. But scale isn't the only thing you can adjust. Let's go back to glossy ABS. As I tap on the already applied material, I'll be able to tweak its color. Nice. Something I particularly love is that when I exit visualization, the modeling space will show the nearest colors applied on my model. So even if I'm not visualizing, I get a general idea of the applied colors and materials. Jokes aside, this is a camera that probably no one would ever buy. So let's revert back to our original materials. I'll use my magic wand for it. That's it.
This camera is looking great. If I were the client, you wouldn't need to say another word. But you know how it goes. When the client can see the design realistically visualized, they're going to understand exactly what they like about the design, but also what they don't like about the design. And when that happens, you're going to need to make changes on the spot.
Visualization was made for moments just like that. Let's go back and edit our camera quickly. First, I'm creating a new button and apply a small fillet on this. Great. Next, I'm going to hide this button just for a while. Now, I'm going to make a small hole in the camera body. I could use a small fillet here as well. Looks great. I'm going to unhide this new button and move it slightly down just to fit perfectly in place. How nice it is. Then, let's go back to visualization. As you can see, the materials are still there, and so is this new part. Let's just quickly add brush steel on it. And that's it. We're done. It only took like a minute. That simple.
And this is huge. If you're using other software, you'd need to go back into your CAD app, tweak the design, export it, re-import it, and redo the render. Total pain.
Obviously, you can use legacy CAD as well, but let's not get into how cumbersome it is to get any editing done with an impatient client breathing down your neck.
And this is why we're confident that visualization is going to be a game changer for our users and their workflow. But don't just take our word for it. Let's hear from a couple of users who've gotten access to visualization and have been tinkering with it over the last couple of days.
When I've seen now visualization coming, I was very happy, very, very happy. The reason is because in our workflow, you don't only model a shape, you need also to check how that shape reacts and behave with different materials. So for a designer, it's important to consider already in the design process which kind of color or material finish you are using for a specific part.
For example, if I'm visiting a client and he asked me to try, okay, let's look at this chair, for example, with different type of wood or some different type of metal, it's good to have a quick rendering solution, like putting just drag and drop something show it to the client.
I usually say to my designers that if you don't have the possibility to test the material immediately, you naturally tend to kind of over-design it because you are too much focused on the shape. And when you see the shape in a traditional CAD visualization shader, you don't realize how that can look like with a nice material.
After I have seen the Shapr3D visualization tool, I really got the motivation to show it to my students because they could really quickly learn it and make their ideas much nicer looking, even in the first class students.
So visualization already fits in a sweet spot in our users' workflow. Now, let's go back to István and hear more about what's next for this feature.
And this is just the beginning. We have crafted this feature for almost a year, but we are still just getting started. With our bi-weekly updates, you will see visualization evolving rapidly. We will keep adding more and more materials and more features like depth of field effect, custom environments and predefined environments, custom lighting options, and even more. Finally, with a single tab, you can quickly iterate on different material variations, run better design reviews with your team and with your colleagues, make better decisions faster, and get client approvals quickly. Shapr3D is now much more than just a design tool. Modeling, technical drawings, and visualization, all in one. An end-to-end workflow in a single tool that you can take anywhere on your iPad or PC tablet. But when you need a bigger screen or more horsepower, you can seamlessly switch to your Mac or desktop PC. Visualization is available today on macOS and iPad, and it's coming soon to Windows. Update Shapr3D today, give it a try, and let us know what you think. We can't wait to see what you are going to do with it.